Example, Mr. X, the testator instituted his friend, Mr. X, as heir to the bulk of his estate. So, the will was made in 1995. So, the bulk of the estate was given to Mr. X in the 1995 will. 10 years later, 2005, the testator heard from various sources that his friend X was already dead. Madami nagsabi sa kanya, tagal na namatay yan. Napatay yan sa Mindanao. Okay? Kailan pa? Matagal na. Sabi niya, he's already long dead. Okay? So, the testator, thinking that his friend X was already dead, makes another will in 2005. And in that second will, he says, among other things, I hereby revoke my 1995 will. Period. After the death of the testator, X appears and learns to his great dismay that the 1995 will had already been revoked by the testator. And he was told by the people who were close to the testator that the only reason why the testator revoked his 1995 will was because the testator erroneously thought that X was already dead. Can X question the validity of the revocation under those circumstances? He cannot. There is no basis. Why? Because in the revocation, the testator simply said, I hereby revoke by 1995 will. He did not state any cause or reason for the revocation. There is no basis for invoking Article 833. You of course remember that even if a will is revoked, any recognition of an illegitimate child contained in that will is not affected. Because a recognition of an illegitimate child is not really in the nature of a testamentary disposition, which is subject to the sole will of the testator. A recognition creates a status, and there must be a certain element of stability insofar as the status of individuals is concerned. Okay. Going now to republication and revival, you remember the difference between the two. Okay? Republication is brought about by the act of the testator. Revival is brought about by the law. Remember the two ways of republishing a will. First, you can republish a will by simply executing a codicil to that will. If you do that, the will is republished as modified by the codicil. You can also republish the provisions contained in a previous will by reproducing those provisions in a subsequent will. As a matter of fact, if the previous will is void as to form, the only way of republishing the provisions contained in that will is by copying the provisions in that will in a new will. You cannot republish the provisions contained in a will which is void as to form by simply executing a codicil to that will. Okay? What is the effect of republication? A will which is republished by a codicil speaks as of the date of the codicil. In other words, it is as if the will was made at the time of the execution of the codicil. And that may have some legal consequences. Let me explain. Let's assume that the testator made a will in 1985. Okay? He makes another will in 1990. A second will. Let us further assume that the provisions of these two wills are inconsistent with each other. Irreconcilable. Okay? If the testator dies with these two wills, which will be given effect? Of course, there is no choice. It's the 1990 will because it is the later expression of the testator's intent. Siyempre, ha, in case of irreconcilable conflict. All right. Let us assume, however, that in 1992, the testator made a codicil. In this codicil, he said, I hereby modify the following provisions in my 1985 will. So the codicil was made referring to the 1985 will, modifying some provisions of that will. What is the effect? The mere execution of the 1992 codicil will have the effect of republishing the 1985 will as modified by the codicil. This means that it is as if the 1985 will was actually made in 1992. Yun ang effect ng republication. Now, assuming there are still irreconcilable conflicts between the provisions of this will and the provisions of the 1990 will, which will now be given effect? Yung 1985 will na. Because it is as if it is the latest expression of the testator's will due to republication. It is as if this will, as modified by the 1992 codicil, was actually made in 1992. Therefore, it would be later than the 1990 will. Remember, however, that republication through a codicil is not possible if the earlier will is void because of form. Hindi pwede ang republication through a mere codicil. If the 1985 will is void because of failure to comply with formalities, the provisions in this will can only be republished by copying them in a subsequent will or codicil. If the testator made his 1985 will in this case when he was only 16 years old, okay, and then in 1992 he makes a codicil to the 1985 will, will the 1985 will be republished? The answer is yes, because it is not defective, it is not void as to form. The problem is with respect to the capacity. But when the codicil was made, he was already fully capacitated to make a will. So there is a valid republication. Pero kung ang defect is with respect to form, halimbawa, 1985 will, notarial in character, walang attestation clause or defective attestation clause, it is not possible to republish that through a codicil. Kung gusto mong i-republish ang provisions, you'll have to copy, reproduce those provisions in a subsequent will. When it comes to revival, isa lang naman ang provision dyan, yung Article 837. The only thing you ask yourself is this. How was the first will revoked by the second will? If a first will is expressly revoked by a second will, forget about revival. Even if the second will is itself revoked by a third will, the first will not be revived. If, however, a first will is merely impliedly revoked by a second will, implied revocation, yung inconsistent lang ang provisions, then, the moment the second will is revoked by a third will, the first will be revived. So, isa lang ang tanong sa revival. How was the first will revoked by the second will? If the first will was revoked expressly by the second will, forget about revival. Hindi posibleng ma-revive yan. If the first will, however, was merely impliedly revoked by the second will, then revival is possible. If the second will is itself revoked by a third will, the first will, which after all was merely impliedly revoked by the second will, that will be revived. Okay? Bukas na natin kunin ang allowance and disallowance. Okay? Anyway, we have the whole day tomorrow and we still have Sunday morning.